Hi, today I'm going to talk about receptor tyrosine kinase. Receptor tyrosine kinase are very important for cell signaling pathway. So today's topics I'll cover mostly how receptor tyrosine kinase works by intracellular signaling pathway and MAP kinase signaling pathway, PI3 kinase, AKT signaling pathway, RAS superfamily, cytoplasmic tyrosine kinase, and cytokine receptor mediated JAK-STAT pathway. And finally, I'll focus some diseases related to these tyrosine kinase mutation. Well, first of all, I want to show you how phosphorylation activate a protein or an enzyme, or even deactivate a protein or enzyme. Kinases are generally add phosphate to a protein or enzyme, and phosphatase remove this protein from that enzyme. Upon addition of phosphate in a protein or an enzyme, this protein or phosphate protein or enzyme become activated, and phosphatase remove that phosphate group and it become inactivated, that is here off. But in some cases, some protein or enzyme become inactivated when phosphate group is added, and it become activated when phosphate group is removed by phosphatase. So these are the main player for activating or deactivating enzymes. Now let us look what are the function of this protein phosphorylation. So it basically involved in some cell development, proliferation pathway, or even degradation pathway. Here just a few examples: cell growth and survival, cell differentiation development, cell cycle control, cell addition and migration, regulation of intracellular signaling pathway, transcription, glucose uptake, platelet activation in blood clotting, angiogenesis, regulation of ion channel activity, neural transmission. However, any abnormality or any mutation of this pathway or this regulation may lead to severe diseases like cancer. Now let us look what are the broad family of tyrosine kinases. Cell surface receptor with intrinsic tyrosine kinase maybe have more or around 20 families. There are 60 genes encoding human receptor tyrosine kinase. Here you can see some big family for EGF receptor, insulin receptor, NGF receptor, PDGF, MCSF receptor, blah blah blah. So what are the basic features of this structure? You can see in the cytosolic side of this receptor, they have all tyrosine kinase domain, that is here in the red sign. So these tyrosine domains actually the key player who mediate the downstream signaling. Well, let us look how it works. Actually, these are some examples. What are the receptors and what are the signal protein? I'm just going to show one example. For example, MCSF receptor. It is macrophage colony stimulating factor. So when MCSF bound to MCSF receptor, it measures some signal. So this is the way how RTK dimerize and it become activated. When a signal molecule bound to these receptor tyrosine kinase, they come closer and dimerize and transphosphorylate each other. And finally, this phosphorylation occurs at several sites of tyrosine residue, and this can serve as docking sites. And if tyrosine kinase domain is somehow mutated, they will be dimerized, but no phosphorylation with each other, and ultimate no activation of signaling pathway. So as I said earlier, the phosphorylation site of the tyrosine residue serves as a docking site for some other signaling molecule, and those signaling molecule have access to site, they can bind this phosphate group. Here you can see enzyme 1, enzyme 2, enzyme 3, these all are binding to this phosphate group because they all have access to domain. And how this domain is organized in the genome. For example, PI3 kinase, GTPase activating protein, or phospholipase C, These all have SS2 domain and SS3 domain. These red are SS2 and fine color is SS3 domain. So this SS2 domain is responsible for binding this phosphate group of tyrosine, and SS3 is a mediator of some another kind of protein. I'm showing in the next slide. And this is some example of RAS family, which are involved in cell mediated signaling or even development or apoptotic pathway. Regulation of RAS protein. RAS protein is regulated by GEF and GAP. GEF dissociate GDP and transfer GDP to RAS protein. So when RAS protein is binding with GDP, it is actually active from, and when RAS protein is binding with GDP, it is inactivated from. GDP bound RAS protein is not activated for whole time. So gap protein just remove this phosphate group and it becomes GDP, that is the inhibited form. How a RAS protein become activated in Drosophila eye? Drosophila eye have two type of cells, which is called R8 cell and R7 cell. R8 cell have cell signaling molecule like BOS protein. BOS protein bind to 7-less receptor, that is a called SEV, SEVRTK. So upon binding BOS to SEV, it become phosphorylated, and phosphorylation serve as a docking site for SS2 containing some other protein, which is called here DRK or adapted protein. In human, this is GRB2. However, this protein has SS3 domain, and SS3 domain just recruit another type of protein, which is called RAS-GEF. So ultimately, as I show in previous slide, RAS-GEF convert RAS-GDP to RAS-GDP. The same mechanism here. Here RAS-GDP is converted to RAS-GTP by the action of RAS-GEF or source protein, and then GTP bound RAS become activated and it causes some downstream signal. And this is same thing, so I'm not going to elaborate it. And these are the some example of RAS mutation in cancer. RAS superfamily like HRAS, KRAS, and NRAS, these all have been found in 30% of human cancer, and especially for pancreatic cancer, 90% is the involvement of RAS. Lung cancer, colon cancer, myeloid leukemia all have responsible for RAS mutation. So mutation in the regulator of RAS also have been found in cancer. For example, the loss of function of mutation like neurofibrillary factor 1 is associated with type 1 neuroblastoma and juvenile myelomonocytic leukemia. This is the classic pathway of MAP kinase, that is mitogen activated protein kinase signaling pathway. This is pretty straightforward. Upon activation of RAS protein, it activates MAP kinase, which is sometimes called RAF, and RAF ultimately phosphorylate MAK, M-E-K, which is called MAP kinase. Just show it. Previous one was MAP kinase. There is triple kinase, then double kinase, then kinase. So they have a special name like RAF, MAK, ARK. So these all are activated by ATP converting to ADP. So finally, MAP kinase, that is ARK, acts like a key player on phosphorylating other gene protein or any regulatory factor required for protein transcription or translation. Now look for PI3 kinase. PI3 kinase actually converted to phosphoinositol. Sometimes you call it PIP2, that is PI452. So upon activation from signal, the PI3 kinase activated this guy, then phosphorylated PIP2 to convert to PIP3, that is 3-phosphate. Then PDK1 and AKT1 can dock in this 3-phosphate group. Finally, AKT is phosphorylated by PDK1 and mTOR1. So here you can see two phosphates, one by mTOR and one by PDK1. So this causes dissociation of this protein, and this will ultimately dissociate bad protein and release inactivated apoptosis inhibitory protein, and ultimately this protein will act like a survival signal of cells, and bad protein will be dissociated or degraded by 14-3-3 protein. Very interesting name, 14-3-3. Now look at some other tyrosine kinases which are not receptor bound but cytoplasmic. So here you can see a big family there actually, SRC, ABL, JAK, BCK, CSK, FAK. So there are a lot of actually, I'm not going to mention it all. So I'll mainly emphasize on two superfamily which are mainly involved in human disease. These are SRC family and another one is JAK-STAT pathway. So SRC family kinase. SRC family kinase consists of several other family protein like SRC, YES, FYN. So you don't have to memorize all. But the important feature is that they all have SS3 domain, SS2 domain, and one kinase domain. The key feature is that SS2 domain is able to bind in phosphorylated site of a activated protein, and SS3 domain is able to bind proline-rich domain or proline-rich motifs like PXXP. Now I'll show you some example. Here is a classical example of SRC kinase activation. So this is the SRC protein. SRC has SS2 domain, SS3 domain, and tyrosine. The phosphorylated form of this is inactive actually. So when this phosphate group is removed, this SRC become activated and the structure becomes slightly loose. When the structure becomes loose, SS2 can now act as player to bind the activating ligand's phosphate group. Here you can see the phosphate group in the activated ligand bind to SS2, and SS3 domain is bind to, this is actually PXXP, that is proline-rich motif. So upon binding this, it become activated and phosphorylated, and now the downstream sequence. Now let us JAK-STAT pathway. JAK-STAT pathway is something called Janus kinase, and previously it was called just another kinase, that is JAK-STAT. And there are big family like JAK1, JAK2, JAK3, and type 2. They also have SS2 domain and some other JS domain. And STAT protein. STAT is a signal transducer and activator of transcription. There are so many STAT family protein, STAT 1, STAT 2, STAT 3, up to STAT 6. So STAT 1 to 6, these molecules can be translocated to nucleus upon activation. And the important feature of this molecule is that they directly transport from cytosol to nuclear membrane just upon activation by JAK-STAT pathway. Now I will show how they act in cellular level. This is the classical example of cytokine receptor signaling. Here you can see cytokine receptors. So cytokine will bind to this receptor site and JAK will come closer, and JAK will transphosphorylate each other, and after getting transphosphorylated, JAK will become activated, and then they will phosphorylate the receptors. And this phosphorylated site will be binded by STAT 1 and STAT 2 because STAT have SS2 binding domain. And after binding, the STATs will become activated and they will dimerize. After being dimerization, they will directly translocate it to a specific promoter site of a gene, and the ultimate help express gene transcription. This is the same thing which I talked, but this is someone showing the interconnect or crosstalk between PI3 kinase or RAS family to JAK-STAT pathway, and these are the other families and various type of cell signaling receptor. So these are summary of all receptor, And now I'll go show some human diseases. So these are the diseases like EGF disease and lymphoma.